fourth phase of voting is underway in India. Polling is taking place in 96 seats across 9 states and 1 union territory. Now, this phase will see the conclusion of polls in the southern states. Simultaneous polls are also taking place for 175 assembly seats of Andhra Pradesh and 28 assembly seats in the eastern state of Odisha. 177 million voters are expected to cast their vote today, with several key candidates like Akhilesh Yadav, Moa Moitra and Arjun Munda making it a high-stakes round. The polling will take place in all the 25 constituencies of Andhra Pradesh and 17 seats in Telangana. Apart from these southern states, polls are also taking place in 13 seats in Uttar Pradesh, 11 in Maharashtra, 8 constituencies of each in Madhya Pradesh and West Bengal, 5 seats in Bihar, 4 each in Jharkhand and Orissa, and 1 seat in Jammu and Kashmir. Now, Jammu and Kashmir is having its first election since 2019 today. Polling is on for the Srinagar constituency for one of the 2 Lok Sabha seats in the Union Territory. Polling for the Anantnag Rajouri seat has been deferred to May 25th. Now, to tell us what's happening on the ground, our reporters have been fanned out across key locations in India. Idris Lone is joining us live from Pulwama. Disha Shah is joining us live from Mumbai. And we, of course, have our Siddharth MP who is joining us live from Chennai. Welcome, all three of you. You've had a long day so far. Idris, if I could start with you. This is the first time elections are happening in Jammu and Kashmir since 2019. Incidentally, that was the same year that Article 370 was scrapped. How is the mood on the ground, Idris?
Well, Aranya, a lot of excitement if we see the situation on the ground. From the last 1 month, we've been seeing that a lot of campaigning happening, aggressive campaigning all across Srinagar city, as well as the new assembly seats that have been added to the Srinagar parliamentary seat. Let me tell you that after the recent delimitation, Srinagar constituency now consists of 5 districts, 2 in South Kashmir, Pulwama and Shopian, Srinagar, Badgam, as well as in Gandharbal. We are right now in Pulwama district in South Kashmir, and I'll ask my cameraman to show you the number of people still on the polling booth. All the previous records of the voting percentage have been broken in Srinagar parliamentary constituency. Last time in 2019, the voting percentage was around 14% in total. But now we are seeing till 1 o'clock, we have around 24% voting percentage of the people in especially in the Srinagar constituency, which now also includes some parts of the South Kashmir. I'll ask my cameraman to pan towards the right and show you that the number of women that we are seeing out and about to cast their vote since morning, and then lines are, and the queue, long queues are really not stopping. Even at this point of time, since morning, we've seen in every polling station there have been huge queues of especially female folks coming to the polling stations to cast their vote. And if we talk about the Srinagar constituency, there are 3 main political leaders in the fray. The first one from the National Conference, Dr. Farooq Abdullah, who's the sitting MP, is not fighting the election this time, and he's given it to another leader from the National Conference to fight for the Srinagar seat. He also has the support of the India Alliance, especially the Congress Party, while as the 2 opponents are, one is from the People's Democratic Party, Waheed Parra, and the other one from Apni Party, Ashraf Mir, who these regional political parties have been claiming that he has the support of Bharatiya Janata Party, as they have not fielded any of the candidates in Srinagar constituency.
All right, Idris, we see some optimism given that in 2019 the voter turnout was lower than 15%. Thanks for that update. Disha, if I could move to you now. Just in the last phase, we were talking about the voter turnout and how it was extremely low, especially in the urban areas. The current data I have from Maharashtra is 30.85%. This was according to 1 a.m. local time, 1 p.m. local time, pardon me. What is the situation right now?
Well, absolutely. Absolutely. Compared to 2019, if you talk about the voter turnout till 1 p.m., this time around, definitely it is very low. In 2019, roughly about 40 to 45% of voters had already voted till 1 p.m. So this time around, even in the initial three phases, we have seen the voter turnout overall in Maharashtra has been quite low if you compare it with the other states. And we are expecting today that maybe after, maybe to closer to the evening, we might expect more voters to go out. Because remember, the western and the northern state of Maharashtra is one of the key vote bank for BJP and for all the parties as well. In 2019, out of 11 constituencies, 7 were won by the BJP. So this time round, definitely it is going to be a very big challenge because there are key concerns as well on the ground level. The Maratha agitation had taken center stage in one of the constituency like Bid, where Pankaja Munde is contesting at this point in time from the BJP side. So whether they'll be able to retain that seat is one of the big questions. We are also looking at another big constituency like Shirur, which comes under the Pune district, where the fight is direct between the NCP versus NCP. So Sharad Pawar has fielded his candidates and even Ajit Pawar on the other side. So it is going to be a very important and key battleground to watch out for. And on the other side, we've also seen that considering this is the farmers and the Maratha voters belt, which always constitutes a large voter bank right. as far as every election is concerned. So a lot of key people have also done rallies in a very big way.
All right. Siddharth, I'll quickly come to you. With this fourth phase of elections, the voting will conclude in the southern belt in India. Now, in this election specifically, the South has been a key focus. But what is your assessment? Has it lived up to the expectation?
Certainly, South is the most important belt as far as the national parties are concerned because they're looking at this region where they can get maximum dividend in order to increase their overall tally. So as far as the BJP is concerned, the ruling party, they're looking to increase their tally in the South so that, you know, they have this lofty goal of 400 plus, including their allies. So the NDA is targeting about 400 plus. So if that's the case, you know, they cannot just bank on their core vote base, voter base in the northern part of the country and the other parts of the country. They'd have to breach the southern bastion, which is where, you know, the BJP has found challenges in the recent past. So in 2019 also, Karnataka was what gave them the bumper harvest. It was 25 out of 28 in Karnataka and Telangana 4. So that's how the right. BJP managed to get close to 30 out of 130 seats in the south. This time around, what they're looking at is they're looking at expanding in Andhra Pradesh. And also Andhra offers them a very unique opportunity because they're one in alliance with the Telugu Desam party and Janasena party, a very formidable alliance. But at the same time, interestingly, in Andhra Pradesh, even the chief minister's party, the incumbents of YSRCP, of Jagan Mohan Reddy, they are also kind of very pro-BJP in a certain sense because on parliamentary issues, they've always supported the BJP because they realize that, you know, for Andhra Pradesh development, they'll have to be pro-BJP. So if need be, there is a possibility that BJP could get outside support from a party that's not directly allied with them. So that's the kind of dynamics we're looking right. at down south. And even overall, south is crucial for the India alliance because this is where in two states they're in power, in Karnataka and Hyderabad they're in power, in Kerala they're in opposition, in Tamil Nadu, the Congress is in alliance with the DMK. So these are, you know, key belts where the India alliance also has a great deal of influence, which is why the south is a very contested region, Ananya.
For all the latest news, download the Vyond app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.